Hello guys, welcome once again. In the last two videos, I have been teaching you about using functions in C++. In this video also, I will be talking about function, and in this specific video, I will show you how to declare and use a function which returns values. So let's get started. By now, you already know how to declare a function. So this time we are going to make the sum of two numbers. So we will make a function which adds two number and returns the sum in the main program. So first of all, we need to decide what we want to return. In the last video, if you noticed, we were returning void, but this time we want to return some value. So this is not void, or this is not null value, but this will be some values. For example, I want to return int this time. So this is called the return value. Whatever data type you want to return, just write in the declaration here and then write the name of the function. For example, sum. And once again, if you want to pass two parameter, just give the declaration of those two parameters here. So int first number and int second number. Okay. And because we are returning this time int here, we need to return some value in order to execute this function. Okay. So this, because we are returning something instead of void, we need to write this return here, or whatever you want to return. So this time what I'm going to do is I will take the sum of these two numbers and I will make the sum and return the value here. So let's see how I can do it. I will declare a third variable called make, or I will say this is my result, which is initialized as 0. Okay. So that there will be no confusion. There will be no garbage value inside result. Then what I will do is I will write result equal to the first number plus the second number. Okay. So what this is doing, I have declared integer as a result, and I'm storing the addition of first parameter and second parameter inside this result. And now what I'm going to do is, because this parameter hold my result, and this function is supposed to get int in return, I will just return this result like this. Okay. So this is the basic definition to return the function. If you want to return int, then you need to declare a function or declare a variable, or return only the variable which is of data type int. If you return here some decimal value, it will give you error because this function is expecting integer in return, right? Now let's call this function inside your main function. So what I'm going to do is, for example, I want to declare one more variable. For example, multiply for mul. Multiply, and then what I'm going to do is I am going to call this function. So I will call this function here and I will pass two parameters, first number and second number. So for example, I pass first integer 253 and second integer 456, and because we are returning some value here, what I can do is I can say let's initialize this by 2. So my multiply variable is initialized by 2, and I will say main. I will declare one more variable, int main result. Okay, and this main result will contain the result. So what I am going to do is I will say main result is equal to this multiply variable into, so for multiplication we use asterisk, remember, and then I'm going to take this function and paste it here. So what this function will do is, let me show you first of all the simple way. This will be a little bit complex to understand for the first time. So let me use cout, and I will say the result is, and then I will call this sum function, and I pass these two values here, and then I will end line. Okay, so what this will do is, this will call this function, add these two values, and return the result in here. So return the result means the sum or the result will be printed here. So for example, I compile this program and run it, it will show me the sum of these two values, right? So what this function is doing, it's taking these two values, making the sum of these two values, and the result it's returning as an int, and it holds the result as an integer. So whenever you call this function, it will return you the sum, right? Now, for example, I want to multiply whatever this function is returning to my variable multiply. Okay, so now I can use this multiply result is equal to multiply into, because this function is returning integer, I can use it as a variable. Okay, so this you can think it as an integer because it's in returning integer, which is the sum of these two values, right? So I can multiply it by another integer, and I can store the product in the third variable called main result, and I will just copy this, and instead of this I can paste it here. So the main result is now the product of whatever the sum of this and the multiply variable. Now I will just build the program and run it, and now you can see, first of all, it makes the sum of these two numbers, and then it multiplies this number by 2, and then it stores the multiplication in this variable, and we are calling this variable here, so it will show the result in this form. So remember this thing, that whenever you return something, you need to give the returning value same data type whatever you have declared here. If you have declared double here, you need to return double value. Okay, and then whatever the function is returning, you can add this function or multiply this function to the another variable because it's returning something. In our case, it's returning integer. Okay, so that's how you can return value using functions. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please rate, comment, and subscribe, and bye for now.